How to Design a Small Group Activity in the Zoom Classroom by Ting Su at San Francisco State University Program in Visual Impairments, viprogram.sfsu.edu.
This is the Special Populations class, and I wanted to show how I do group work in the synchronous format. What I wanted to show you was I have the Zoom recording for this class. So I'm going to go and play the Zoom recording for you guys. And what you're going to see is basically, Adam has just finished his lecture and it's just, showing a PowerPoint and talking. And now I want the students to break out into groups and do some stuff. So this in-class group work, again, it's very important to give the students like the access to the information kind of ahead of time and during the Zoom lecture. So here, I just have the Word document of like what everybody needs to refer to for the group work, and you're gonna see it in the recording. And then I also have the link to the Google Slides that the students are gonna actually work on during class. And this is a link that I will also put chat to them in the chat box when we begin the activity, so that in case I don't already have it pulled up, I don't lose class time. And I don't have to wait for people to go on iLearn and click this. So I'm actually going to grab this link for you guys so then I can give it to you in the chat box. And yeah, sometimes you're gonna be looking around your computer like this, but the students get used to it and they hang out. Okay, I'm gonna show you how I set things up in Google Drive. So that it's very easy to basically have the template set up and you can basically just like rerun it every year. So this is my class folder for special populations. I have a templates folder where everything is just blank. So then when it comes the new year, I just go to the template, I make a copy and I put it into the new year's folder. So this cuts down on a lot of that prep work. The thing that we're going to look at today that goes with the activity, and actually let me give you guys both the Word doc and the link to this drive so that you can get that experience of what the students get.
And here I am in my Zoom window, and a neat little feature in Zoom is that you can actually drag and drop files into the chat window to share. So I've got my Finder window up, and I'm simply going to click on the file that I'd like to share. And here I go, I'm gonna click it, I'm gonna drag it over here into the chat, and I drop it into the chat box, and ba-doom! There it is now in the chat box. So I've got my Word doc that I wanna share with the class that, again, I have also posted on iLearn, so students do have that beforehand. And I'm gonna go into my Google Slides. I have the slides pulled up that I would like to share with the class, and I am going to share with them. And when I click share, I do want to be sure that the sharing settings are on edit access. So this way, anybody with the link can edit the Google Slides, which is exactly what I want to happen during this in-class small group activity. So once the sharing settings are on can edit, I go ahead and copy the link. I click done to get rid of this window. I go back to my Zoom by, on my Mac, it's a command tab to pull up this application shifter. And now I'm back in Zoom, I go to my chat box and I just simply do a command V to paste that link to the Google Slides in. I hit enter and boom, both the links to the Word doc and also the Google Slides is right there in that chat box. And it makes it very easy to students to just click on it when they're in class and they're immediately in the file that you want them to be working on.
So now you guys have the Google Drive thing, you have the scenarios, and I'm gonna play the video of class so you can kind of see how I introduce it and then how it runs with the breakout groups. So share the screen again. So what you're seeing here is basically the class recording. I think this should be queued up in the right place. All right, so you'll see this Word document. There's four different scenarios. Group one, you'll be in scenario one. Group two, group three, scenario three, group four, scenario four. Let's focus on like, visualizing NOAA. So
hopefully, yeah, I gave you guys a link to the Land of Noah last week, and hopefully you guys got a chance to poke around the website enough to get a sense of Noah, okay? what I'd like you to do is, given the scenario, so imagine like Noah being in each of these scenarios, I want you guys to get in your groups and work through these four items. So each of your groups should have a mixed bag of TVI and O&M students. So what I'd like you to do is, you know, O&M, you put on your O&M hat, TVIs, put on your TVI hat. Given this scenario, identify one need from your related perspective and consider what are the needs related to access, communication, inclusion with peers and active participation, and how the student maintain her dignity in this scenario. Then I want you guys to brainstorm how you're going to represent this activity so that it's meaningful to Noah. So, like, if this were going to be, like, calendar item on her calendar, how would you represent this? Or how would you let her know that it's time to go on the bus or that it's time to play, it's time to go to the bathroom or time to eat? And then once you've got a good idea of what the major needs are and how you would, like, represent and communicate the activity, then brainstorm, how would you train the staff on how to support Noah in the scenario? And how would you provide recommendations for the family?
So basically, you know, after explaining the activity, I used the breakout room option and I shot them out into their groups. And then it's really neat because then I can go into the Google Drive. And if you guys click into the Google Drive document now, you know, each group basically went to each slide to work on their thing. I tend to like the Google Slides format because then as people are working on their in their group and putting information in, the document doesn't jump around, you know? Like if it was in a Google Doc and people put things in a Word doc, it like the whole thing just kind of jumps around a lot. It's a little bit harder to follow. So that's why I like the Google Drive format because people just put things on a slide and each slide is kind of contained within the group. So you guys are able to see how each group filled in each item. The other thing about using the Google Slides is that now they've got like a handout to take away with them from class. And they can compare and contrast what each other did. They can look at different perspectives of how different groups approached the problem or an activity. And they also have access to this long-term. So like each class has that Google folder that I showed you initially, they all have that link in their course materials area. So they have like a Google Drive folder that's for this class that they can go back and refer back to materials. So it's important that in your course materials section, they get the link to the Google folder, but then in the iLearn week, they have the link to this particular file that you want them to work on. Otherwise, people get confused very easily about where to find. You know, in the bottom, like where you see chat, share, pause, stop recording, closed caption, There's a button that says breakout rooms. And when you click breakout rooms, it'll say assign participants into however many rooms. So you can adjust the number of rooms to match the number of groups that you want. So one thing about the breakout rooms, there's going to be a little bit of a pause when I do the breakout rooms because they are in assigned groups for this particular project. So when I create the breakout rooms, I'm actually like creating the room and like plopping people into each group. A much quicker way is just to do like automatic breakout rooms and it'll randomly shoot people into the rooms. But because I wanted to make sure there were like an even number of TVIs and O&Ms in each group, I made assigned groups. When people are in the rooms, you can blast a message to be like, hey, remember to do this. Or, hey, we're going to come back in 5 minutes. So you don't totally lose contact with people when they're in the rooms. So know that when you click to close the breakout rooms, it takes 60 seconds to close. So I always like to close it. So you don't like lose too much class time, you know. So yeah, basically I say, okay, goodbye guys, I'll see you in 10 minutes. And that was another thing I learned is before you break out into groups, you should tell them how much time they have. So,
yes.
So then they know how much time to budget for.
And that concludes my demo on how to design a small group activity in the Zoom classroom. Yes, it does take a little bit of setup just to get your Google Slide template ready and the Google links set up, but once you get going, it's really not that bad, and it's just kind of cool to reimagine how to do this kind of instructional activity in the virtual classroom. So thanks for watching, and good luck out there. Bye.